Hello food lovers and welcome once again to my channel. Today I have a phenomenal apple pie for you. A very crunchy and homemade crust, a lovely white chocolate creme patisserie and thin apple slices. The crust is so soft and crumbly, the white chocolate creme patisserie so smooth and creamy. And let's start making the crust. You don't have to be a scientist to make the perfect crust. Just put all the ingredients inside the mixer and this is it. We need the flour inside, icing sugar, a little bit of cinnamon, salt, and of course good quality butter. We need good butter to make the crust very, very tasty and very, very aromatic. Cut it in small pieces like this. And that's it. If you don't have this mixer, you can do it by your hand. Put everything together in a bowl, mix everything together with your hands, and the crust will be ready. But this is the easiest way. At this point, the crust is ready. Pour all this lovely base in the pot. And with your hand, make it look nice and sexy. Please guys, the butter should be chilled. And if the butter is chilled, the crust will be perfect. Now, easy, huh? Now it's time to bake it 170 for 30 minutes. And when it's ready, we'll carry on with the patisserie. My crust is ready. And look at this golden brown color. It is perfect. Now, it's time to prepare the patisserie. Now, for the patisserie, the things are very simple, but please follow my instructions. You have to make sure that you follow my instructions to be perfect. We have all these lovely ingredients here, and you have to follow the rules of patisserie. So, pour all the milk inside the pot, but keep about 100 ml on the side, like this. Now, pour the half sugar inside, and this mixer goes on heat. Now, why we put the half sugar here? Because we have to protect, to prevent the milk to burn. Because if we don't add the sugar, the milk will burn, and we don't want that. Now, the other half sugar is here, and we have the egg yolks, and we will add the yolks and the sugar in a bowl. From the moment that sugar touches the surface of the egg yolks, we have to whisk, because if we don't, the egg yolks will become omelette, and this is something we don't want. So whisk with the speed of light to make sure that the yolks will become creamy and nice. Now, in this patisserie we use cornstarch, that's why we need the milk on the side. If we don't use cornstarch, we pour all the milk inside the pot. Now, after the yolks are ready, add the milk. Carry on whisking, add the cornstarch, and guess what? Carry on whisking. We need to dissolve the cornstarch. Now we need to give a nice flavor to this patisserie, so add a little bit of vanilla extract. Bravo. Carry on whisking. And it's time to transfer ourselves next to the pot. As you can see, the milk starts to boil. Can you see that? And this is the moment that we have to slowly pour the milk inside the egg mixture, like this. So it will not burn the eggs. Slowly, 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 slowly.
Wow.
Nice. Now, the pot goes again on heat, and all this lovely mixer inside the pot. And this is it. Now, carry on whisking until the patisserie is set. When it's set, we'll take off the heat and we'll add the butter and of course the white chocolate. When the patisserie is thick and you have this consistency and you see bubbles on the surface, then it's ready. Take it out and it's time to add the white chocolate and the butter. Now we're doing that at the end because we want to reduce the heat of the patisserie. This way the patisserie will get cold, and with the fat at the end the patisserie will become firm and very, very smooth. Carry on whisking until you see all the butter melts. And that's it. White chocolate patisserie is ready. Now it's time to pour this lovely patisserie on the top of this lovely crust. Look at this. You want to just eat the whole patisserie from the pot like this, but we have to make a nice apple pie, so please carry on. You can leave some on the pan to try later. And now it's time to add the apples. You can choose any apples you like. I have some red one, I have some green one. You can take whatever apple you like. Now, I will show you how we'll make the line of apples on top of the patisserie. First, you have to take off the skin of the apple. Use a peeler or your knife, like this. And actually, I like to use different kinds of apples because it gives a different texture and, of course, different flavors at the apple pie. Now, the skin is off. Take off the seeds. This way. Cut in half. And with your knife or a nice mandolin, slice the apple like this. I prefer to do it with my knife. And of course, because I want to practice my skills, my knife skills, that's why you have to use your knife also. The knife is knife. Now, when the apple is ready, take your hand this way, spread it. Take your knife like this and put the first line of apple on the top of patisserie, like this. I will carry on with the rest of the apples until the surface is completely covered. And my lovely apple pie is ready to be baked. But before, we have to sprinkle some sugar, granulated sugar on top, to caramelize the apples and, of course, to make a crispy crust on the top. Should be enough, maybe a little bit more. So, everything is ready. Patisserie is ready, the base is ready, so we have only to give a nice golden color to the apples. Broil for 10 to 15 minutes until it's golden brown and nice. And when it's ready, take it out, let it cool for half hour, and then we will serve it. And my apple pie is ready to be served. Now, look at this. Amazing. A little bit more for my friend Lucky's. And look at this. Amazing! And so rustic, so homemade, and so, so nice. A little bit of ice cream on the top. And the ice cream on the top. Vanilla ice cream. I don't know why, but I will put some rosemary here. It's nice. And of course, some cinnamon. And look at this. Beauty and so, so tasty. Now, I have to try, because I have to, and explain you what is the aftertaste of this dessert. It is so yummy, really. So many textures. Underneath, it's so crunchy and so buttery. On top, it is so fruity and so nice. Because we have a lot of apples, you can feel these fruits. And of course, it is crunchy on top. And in between the fruit and the base is the lovely white chocolate patisserie. So balanced dessert and so, so tasty. If you try this recipe, I know that you will love me. I know that you will subscribe to my channel and make comments underneath the video. See you next time. Bye bye. Yassas.